All right, we'll move on to some other important news. The story we're about to show you is very disturbing and graphic. It is about rape as a weapon in Libya's civil war and evidence of those assaults that the rebels say are frequently found on captured cell phones. As CNN's Sarah Seidner explains from Misrata in Libya, the videos are so awful that even the rebels are trying to erase the evidence to avoid humiliating victims and their families. We should tell you that we have blurred a lot of the video to make it possible for Sarah to file this report.
On the front lines of Libya's war, rebel fighters say they are finding a lot more than weapons on captured or killed pro-Gaddafi soldiers. They say they have confiscated cell phones that contain videos showing Gaddafi loyalists torturing and raping Libyan citizens.
After weeks of hearing of these cell phone rape videos, we for the first time have a copy of one. This was given to us by a source who does not want to be identified for fear of being punished by this very conservative society. To be clear, we have been unable to verify its authenticity. We don't know where it was taken or when or by whom. All we can do is watch it and listen to it.
In this video provided to CNN from what rebels say was the cell phone of a Gaddafi loyalist, two men in civilian clothes stand over a naked woman who is bent over with her face on the floor. The man standing behind her is sodomizing her with what appears to be a broomstick. I can't bear it. I can't bear it, she says. A male voice off camera says, let's push it farther. No, no, that's enough, the woman begs. One of the men puts his sock-covered foot on her face. In this culture, it is considered the ultimate insult. But in this case, it pales in comparison to what the victim is already enduring.
We blurred this video because it's extremely difficult to watch. Arabic speakers who have examined the video say the voices in the video are distinctly Libyan with clear Tripoli accents. There is no date on the video, and the men in the video are not wearing military uniforms. The victim's face is barely seen, so we have not been able to identify her. It has been extremely difficult to get anyone to talk about this video on camera because of the cultural sensitivities here.
We asked Abdullah Al-Kabir, a spokesman for the opposition in Misrata, whether rebels have found many of these kinds of videos. His answer, yes.
We were able to confirm that rape was used as a weapon of war because it was systematic.
The International Criminal Court in The Hague says the allegations are credible. It is investigating. But in a surprising admission to CNN, spokesman Al-Kabir tells us some of the very evidence of war crimes prosecutors want may have been destroyed.
There was a commander here at the Eastern Front in Misrata named Mohammed Al-Halbous. He ordered all the revolution's fighters to give him all the rape videos they found on Gaddafi's soldiers' cell phone. I heard that he used to destroy every rape video he got.
Why in the world would you destroy video evidence of rape that could be used as evidence of war crimes against your enemy, against the Gaddafi regime?
Because aside from being a heinous crime, rape is perceived here in our culture as damaging not only for the girl, but also the whole family.
Rape is such a taboo in this culture, even some of the victims' families would rather erase potential evidence against the attackers than risk living with the shame. Sarah Seidner, CNN, Misrata, Libya.
And this just coming in, the Gaddafi government has not responded to CNN's numerous requests for comment, but the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, has just released this statement on the situation, and let me read it to you in its entirety. Gaddafi security forces and other groups in the region are trying to divide the people by using violence against women and rape as tools of war. And the United States condemns this in the strongest possible terms. It is an affront to all people who are yearning to live in a society free from violence with respect for basic human rights. We urge all governments to conduct immediate, transparent investigations into these allegations and to hold accountable those found responsible. Strong statement from Hillary Clinton. The use of rape as a tool of war in Libya.
The Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, saying people close to the Libyan leader Muammar Gaddafi may be ready to negotiate a deal that would remove him from power regarding our third war, the not war in Libya. But Secretary Clinton is not giving any more details. She made the announcement during a NATO coalition meeting in our not war in Libya. Keep in mind, this is not the first time we've heard this sort of thing, but Gaddafi remains in power. And earlier this week, Gaddafi himself insisted he will not surrender and that he will fight to the death. All of this as NATO launches fresh airstrikes in the not war on the capital city of Tripoli. British officials also announced today they plan to step up military operations there.
While obviously it's a, it's a scary and an uncertain situation, with regards to counterterrorism, we're still very much continuing our operations.
Panetta also told Congress he believed Libyan leader Muammar Gaddafi's days are numbered. And as he did so, Secretary of State Clinton promised more U.S. help to the Libyan opposition. Attending a gathering in the United Arab Emirates, Secretary Clinton said Washington would contribute another $26 million in humanitarian aid to the Libyan opposition, and she made clear the NATO military strikes will continue unless and until Colonel Gaddafi yields power.
There is only one way forward for Libya. Attacks against civilians must stop. Gaddafi must go, and the Libyan people deserve to determine their own future.
So let's discuss the dramatic changes and the challenges in the Middle East and North Africa with Senator Dianne Feinstein of California. She leads the Senate Select Committee on Intelligence. Senator, thank you for your time tonight. I want to start with your friend, the CIA director and the soon-to-be Defense Secretary, Leon Panetta, was on Capitol Hill today for his confirmation hearing. As he moves over to the Defense Department, we are right now at day 83 since the NATO operations started in Libya. I want you to listen to Director Panetta, soon-to-be Secretary Panetta's assessment of the situation on the ground in Libya.
We have seen the opposition make gains both in the east and the west. I think there are some signs that if we continue the pressure, if we stick with it, that ultimately Gaddafi will step down.
Senator, you hear Leon Panetta there say ultimately Gaddafi will step down. You have this remarkable situation in which NATO, with the United States' blessing, is accelerating airstrikes, and everybody now publicly is saying they will keep bombing until Gaddafi leaves, when the United Nations resolution that authorized these military strikes says regime change is not the goal.
Well, I'm not going to get into that because Gaddafi is the beginning of all of this, and he's also the end of it. There is no alternative other than Gaddafi leaving office. This is a bad man. He has not been good for his country, and I think he ought to go. And the president has very strongly said he ought to go. So I think efforts that are aimed at moving Mr. Gaddafi out of the country and out of his command and control areas, out of his palaces, are really very important to carry out now.
Secretary Clinton said Washington would contribute another $26 million in humanitarian aid to the Libyan opposition, and she made clear the NATO military strikes will continue unless and until Colonel Gaddafi yields power.
There is only one way forward for Libya. Attacks against civilians must stop. Gaddafi must go, and the Libyan people deserve to determine their own future.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
TeamHillaryClinton.com.